play a little bit of this song. I'm going to play the part of the song that I probably want to spend the next 5 minutes on, and I may go to the next song. We'll just see what we have after this. So let's go. Here we go. This is the intro. Let's talk about it. So with this tune specific to Ableton, let's talk about that. So you see this with this new vocal intro. Let me tell you how this came about. This came about because the label did not like the first intro. I was like, whoa. And we had like this huge drop there. And I thought it was really cool. However, the song is called Come Alive, and it was too close for comfort in terms of The Greatest Showman. They have a song called Come Alive, and they had an intro. I think the song is called Come Alive, where they did this these woes at the beginning, and it was the same kind of similar thing. We actually mimicked it on purpose because we thought it was really cool. We thought we could get away with doing our own version, but the lawyers of the label were like, eh, yeah, no. Let's go with no for $3,000. So what I did was I had this idea, and I didn't have time because we were, you know, stumped for time, and I'm like, man, what are we going to do? So I didn't have the time to just deliberate, but I had this idea of this. I've always enjoyed creating my own samples, and so I'm like, all right, bet. Let me sample myself. And that's what I did. So when you see all of this down here, it is literally where you see bass vocals 1 through 4 and the low hum and all of this stuff. This is actually all me. I'm going to play it, and then I'm going to tell you how I did it. Okay, so let me tell you how I did it. I basically slowed everything down. And I don't know if everything in this is warped. Let me check something. So it's not. So I won't show you that. But I'll show it to you this way. I'm going to solo this. Okay, so with one of the things I love about Ableton, I'm going to move this over. And so you guys can see what I'm actually doing. So my tempo here, okay, so I'm at 148. I did not record this at 148. I actually slowed it down to probably like 100, and I recorded myself. Some of it I actually recorded in a different key and changed the key and the tempo, and that's how you get that sampled flavor, right? So if you look, this is currently warped. If I unwarp this here, hum ad lib 1, you're going to see it move. See that? This is the original vocal. It sounds like this. Okay, so that's the original. But once I speed Ableton back up, and I can do this in real time, by the way. All right, so watch this. If I want to go slower, still the integrity's still there. All right, that's one thing I love. Again, when you press play in Ableton, you don't have to stop. You can keep going until you're done. I love that. And so I just stacked my vocal over and over and over and over and over, and I was able to kind of get that, kind of create this vintage choir, okay? Slave choir. I don't know what it was. A really, really vintage choir. I loved it. Worked out. Song got approved. The rest is history. But things like that you can do in Ableton on the fly. That is something that I think is absolutely incredible. I can't do that in Logic. I can't do it, at least not on the fly. I have done it in Logic, but there's so many more steps that I have to do. All of my haze and all of that stuff, I'm doing that stuff on the fly. So I'm dragging and dropping. I'm duplicating down the timeline, and I'm doing a lot of that stuff in real time. So that is the major strength of Ableton.